Hey everyone, in today's video, I will be showing you a calendar AI agent, and you can use this agent to basically see all in your Google Calendar. You'll be able to add events, delete events, add attendees, and more. Now, the reason why I'm using my Google Calendar is because in a real life environment, I use Google Calendar in my business and personal, and even on my iPhone when I try to sync with Google, sometimes it's off and I have to go into Google anyway. So I just thought, why don't we create an AI agent that I can talk to pull the events and make changes a little bit quicker and faster, along with Google Meet meetings already scheduled. We're going to do the demos first, and then we'll break down each scenario after. What do I have on my calendar today? As you guys can see, I sent a voice message, and we can go here into the n8n executions tab and see that it is personally running, and we should get a response back any second now. It succeeded, and it showed us that we do have events scheduled along with the attendees and everything throughout that session. So just to confirm that this is real and this is scheduled for today, let's go into our actual calendar, ETP Tech. That's the name of my company. And as you can see, we just had a team scrum that was today. I have a deep work session coming up that was scheduled for 1:15 that matches a client presentation and also a production release. And as you can see, that's for 7 p.m. So everything checks out. But let's take it a step further, and we can actually stay here on this screen to see an update in real time. Let's go ahead and move this deep work session 30 minutes back. Move my deep work session to 30 minutes a little bit later. I tripped up on my words a little bit there, but let's see how the AI agent handles that and actually moves the session back. And as you guys can see, it just did it. It did it very fast, actually. That's a little bit quicker than us actually going into this, clicking edit and then clicking another button, clicking save. So it happens a little bit faster, and it's a little bit more natural too as well. Just talk to the AI agent as if it was your personal assistant. But hey, I noticed that the client presentation is at 4, and the client didn't tell us that they did not want to go to the meeting today. They just sent us a Slack. They didn't deny the meeting at 4 p.m. So let's go ahead and remove this client presentation meeting that we have scheduled and see how the AI agent handles that. Go ahead and delete the client presentation meeting I have today. So we're going to see this happen live. It's taking the voice message, transcribing it, and then going to deliver the results to our calendar agent. Let's see what it does here. As you guys see, it just deleted the presentation. Again, this was a little bit quicker than us having to click the actual presentation, then press delete, and then making sure that it's off of everyone's calendar. Another example, guys, of how using an AI agent can speed up a lot of things and become more efficient. Let's get into the AI agent and see how it actually performed these actions. We're here in the editor of n8n, and we're going to pull up scenario one and plug the data inside of the workflow. So I can do just click copy to editor here, unpin, and you'll see it's going to append all of the data from our first executed scenario. And if you remember, the first scenario essentially was asking, what meetings do I have on my calendar right now? I'm going to exit out of this chatbot so we can put this full screen. And I just exited out of the AI agent chatbot space so we can focus on the workflow of this screen. And if we go here into the node when executed by another workflow, it's sending in this query from another AI agent, the parent agent, as I like to call it. And in the query, it does ask, what events do I have scheduled on my calendar for today? And then the parent AI agent, it does know as a point of reference the date it is today. Now, as we go next into the actual brain and in the LLM powering the brain, we will go in here into our calendar agent. Nothing you guys haven't seen before, but it's sending in a query or input parameter into the brain of the agent within the prompt. And it's saying exactly what we stated before in the node. And our system message is how we're building out the AI agent to make sure it knows what tool to call upon when it's time for it to receive a user message. So if we go here into our tools, you'll see here, these are all of our tools that we've created. Create event with attendee, get event, update event, and deleted event. We practice most of these scenarios here, but in this case, we did just say, hey, we need the events for today. So let's see what that looks like in the get events node. Here in this get events node, you have the left part of the brain, which is the input, the information received. As you can see here, this is very similar to all of the other nodes that I show you where we set the tool description, meaning it's a tool that automatically can be called upon by the AI agent brain. The resource is event, so we're looking for events. The operation, we're trying to get any event that we're looking for, just get them all. From the list, we're choosing my own personal account. We're not doing return all events because quite often I'm not having more than 10 events on my schedule. As time goes by and I do start having more events on my schedule, let's say we hit 10, 15, I hope it never hits 20 events in a day, then we will up this limit to make sure it's retrieving all events. Next, in the after field, all this is saying is, hey AI, estimate the day before the user is requesting. So it knows today's date is actually February 26th. Tell us the day before so we know what the day is after. And it does know that the day after is February 27th. But I played around with this. I learned that having the day before and the day after switched around signifies to the AI agent that is giving us a range of days. And those range of days, we have to pick the range that's right in the middle, which is today. And when I switched these around, it didn't work when I had day before and the day after field. It was very weird how it actually turned out. I kept it just like this and it all seemed to work out. And it's, from my understanding, it does know that the day before is February 25th and the day after is February 27th. So having it switched around like this allowed us to pick the right date, which is today. Next, we also have the output right here, which is all of the events that it found within the given date. And what that is doing is sending all those IDs of the event back up to the AI agent brain. And then once it hits this AI agent brain, it basically says, hey, take this piece of information and spit it back out so we can send it back to the user. And this was the result. We're in scenario two now. And if you remember, we had to move our deep work session to about 15 to 30 minutes out from when it was originally scheduled. So let's go ahead and look at the data that was transmitted during that session. Now we have when the executed by another workflow node, it took the query was summarized to move deep work power session scheduled for that date from 115 to 145. The parent AI agent knew what the date was and knew that I wanted to move it about 30 minutes out. And it basically did that calculation in its own brain before sending it down for the contact agent to use. So if we go here into the actual brain to actually see what it did with that query, we can go into our system message right here and see that when it's time to update an event, you must use the get events first to get the ID of the event to update. So let's see what that looks like in the tool. So we go here and we're getting the event first. That's what we asked for. And again, we just went over this after and before section so we can know exactly what date to pull from for this specific event. It pulled from this subset of information of the event we're looking for, which was the deep work session. And it placed that information back into the calendar agent so we know exactly what event we're talking about. And when it did that, it sent that information down into the tool called update event. And then from there, it already had the event ID and we had AI fill that out and take an estimated guess on what that event ID was from the information retrieved before in the previous tool. And then from there, we also told AI to change the time and it took an estimate about what the time we wanted to move it to. And using this JSON code, it allows the AI to estimate and guess what time we want the end time and the beginning time of the meeting to be updated to. And this all comes from the query and then the AI agent brain itself critically thinking through the information that we gave it. And it spit out the new event details and sent that back to the AI agent brain. And once we sent it up to the AI agent brain, it determined that our deep work session has been successfully moved and they sent that back to us. Now we're going to move into the next scenario. We're in scenario three. And in this scenario, we deleted one of our client sync meetings because they did not want it anymore and they forgot to say that they weren't coming. So we had to manually delete it. We're going to go into our when executed by another node or workflow, delete the client presentation meeting scheduled for February 26, 2025. And so it took that query, placed it in the AI agent brain. We have a system message in there that we can go and view. It's saying use the delete event to delete event. And then it's saying that you first must recall the events first by using the get events tool to ensure that we have the ID to make sure we properly delete the right event. We came into our get events. Again, we told the AI agent to call the get events tool first. This looks exactly like our previous scenario. It pulled all of the events back from today to know all of the different event IDs we need to find the right client meeting event. And we sent that back up into the AI agent brain, and the AI brain took that information, went into the delete event tool and gave it its own client ID. And we programmed this for the AI to do it all itself. Again, there is room for error and there's ways we can mitigate room for error as we go forward. I will be approving this AI agent as we go forward, guys. But I just wanted to show you how this works in real time. And this output that you see here was just confirmation that this ID is a real ID within our own account and we can proceed forward with deleting this event. So it sent that information that it was true back up to the calendar. It successfully deleted the event and it said the client presentation meeting has been successfully deleted. Lastly, if it couldn't find that event, then it would say try again. We could not find that event. All right, everyone, that concludes today's video. That's a short one. If you want to receive this exact AI agent for completely free, you can join my community with the link down below. You'll be able to collaborate with a bunch of people that's working to upskill themselves to be constantly in demand in an ever-changing workforce. And you can collaborate on new agents. You guys can share agents, share new builds, share different versions, and also follow along with me as I continually improve these agents as I go throughout my own personal life and within my business. Also is the link to join my free newsletter where I'll share global insights of emerging technologies, new updates about AI and automations and AI agents, and everything in between about technology is completely free and is delivered to your email inbox at least 3 times a week. I will see you guys in the next video and remember to embrace your potential.